usually when I get a chance to talk about sex education, I'm with teachers and nurses and counselors.
These teachers and administrators in Beckley, West Virginia, are learning how to teach students comprehensive sex education. Part of their day is spent role-playing how to answer students' tough questions.
How do you know if you're ready to maybe have sex?
Well, local education officials, frustrated by the state's teen pregnancy rate, started this initiative 3 years ago. Nora Galperin from the nonprofit Advocates for Youth leads sessions like this all over the country.
It's more than just condoms and abstinence. It's talking about relationships and dating violence and talking about communication. How do you break up with someone? How do you say no if someone's pushing you to do something you're not comfortable doing? All of those skills that both young people need and adults need as well.
West Virginia requires middle and high school health classes to cover sex education, but it's up to the discretion of the individual principals and teachers how in-depth they teach it. The only mandatory topic by law is HIV, the virus that causes AIDS. Galperin says there's no consistency to the way sex ed is taught within the state or across the country.
It's a real patchwork of policies. About half of the states currently have a policy at the state level, and half the states don't. A lot of students will tell you it's too little, too late. It comes too late in their education if they get it at all.
Since the 1990s, teen pregnancy and birth rates decreased across the United States. But in the mid-2000s, West Virginia's rates spiked in the opposite direction. Today, it has the eighth highest teen birth rate of the 50 states. Kirsten Edwards is one of those teen mothers, raising her two-year-old daughter, Aubrey, while staying in high school. Edwards got pregnant at 14.
I was still a freshman, and I was just like, you know, there's no possible way I could have done that. And it was a big surprise to me.
A surprise, even though she says she didn't use contraception properly.
We were young, you know, he was my first. We didn't use as much protection as we should have, and we didn't try to prevent it, but we also didn't think that it could happen.
Aubrey, where's the puppy?
Before her pregnancy, Edwards had one sex ed class a year in her middle school.
It was like one, basically an hour, and they told us everything, and then in eighth grade they told us everything again, but it was like, it was once a year where they did this.
Kirsten's mother, Brandy Surratt, is helping raise her granddaughter and babysits while Kirsten attends school. She says she taught her daughter about sex.
Yeah, if they teach it a lot more in school and not only at home too, you know, I think things could have been prevented.
And so you're in favor of having a more comprehensive sex education?
Oh, yes. Don't just teach them, hey, abstinence is the best, here's a condom. No. Don't hand them out condoms. Teach them about all sorts of different birth controls. You're not going to change a teenager's hormones no matter how much you preach. It's not going to work because teenagers are hormonal and things happen.
Of every eight babies that were born in West Virginia, one was born to a teen mother. I mean, I think that's crazy.
Selena Vickers is a state health coordinator who is trying to improve the sex ed curriculum.
West Virginia is a very high poverty state anyway. Teen pregnancy is just part of the cycle of poverty. And if we want our kids to break the poverty cycle, we have to stop them from becoming mothers and fathers before they're ready.
Motivated by studies showing that teenage girls who are taught comprehensive sex ed are less likely to become pregnant, Vickers started training teachers in a curriculum that's been adopted across the U.S. called FLASH. It covers not only abstinence, but also consent, birth control, sexually transmitted diseases, sexual orientation, and sexual abuse. So far, schools in only 20 of the state's 55 counties use FLASH. The federal government funds a similar program, but also still promotes abstinence only through Department of Health grants that started in the 1980s. West Virginia is one of 35 states still getting the funds, despite studies showing that abstinence only has no overall impact on teen sexual activity and can cause an increase in teen birth rates.
We've put millions and millions and millions of dollars into abstinence-only programs, and what every bit of research has shown is that it does not work. Kids that go through abstinence only often have much higher rates of STDs and pregnancy because they didn't have another option. They didn't know what, how to protect themselves.
In rural McDowell County, as recently as 2012, 1 in 10 teenage girls became pregnant, which was the highest rate in West Virginia. That's why Nelson Spencer became one of the first school superintendents in the state to adopt the flash curriculum in 2014.
We always give the parents the choice to opt out of any class that we have that they would think would be controversial. So it's not forced upon any student that does not want to have that education. Whether it's sex education or whether it's English, we want our kids to be prepared to go in the future and be knowledgeable about any topic that comes along that we teach in McDowell County.
In addition to the new flash curriculum, McDowell County schools offer an after-school elective sex ed program called Teen Talk. 15-year-old Montana Dye and 17-year-old Rachel Hendrickson attended. Both say they barely had any sex ed in middle school.
We had health and that was about it. And they mainly went over like the bone structure and dieting and exercising.
How much knowledge did you have before you took the after-school program?
I didn't know that much about teen pregnancy and stuff and how much it actually matters, because I didn't believe that it matters that much and how much it costed to keep care of a kid.
So what were some of the gaps in your knowledge about sex education?
The different types of birth control, I thought it was just a pill and a condom, but there's much more. You can get an injection in your arm to prevent it.
So did you find that information helpful?
Yeah, it really did help.
Dave Perry, a teacher and principal for 35 years who sits on the State Board of Education, says he prefers a simple sex ed curriculum that stresses abstinence only.
I think it's fundamental because it's biblical. And I think abstinence is foolproof 100%. Anything apart from that, far as contraceptives and so forth, has a margin of error, but abstinence doesn't.
Perry says his religious objections to teaching more than the minimum about sex are shared by many people in this state.
I think it's more responsibility of parents, and parents have a right to do that. And I think as education, we've become more social institutions than we have educational institutions. And we're dealing quite a bit with social problems and issues that I don't think our educators are that qualified or certified to address.
Perry worries comprehensive sex ed could make teenagers want to have sex.
With contraceptives and condoms and so forth, I think it's an encouragement. You know, it's a green light that this is possible without bearing children. So I think to what extent you teach, what you teach, you get.
If you start talking about sex, it doesn't make, you know, teenagers run down the street and be sexually active. So
Jenny Yost, an OBGYN affiliated with Marshall University in nearby Huntington, teaches Teen Talk.
Abstinence only works if you're abstinent. And what we know about teenagers is that in ninth grade, about 30%, this is nationwide data, 30% in ninth grade are sexually active. That number goes up to close to 60% by 12th grade. When we look at actually comprehensive sex education and covering all of these topics, you know, data has shown that, you know, those students that participate in those programs have, you know, less, they delay sexual activity, they have less sexual partners, or more compliant with things like condoms and contraception.
18-year-old high school senior Isom Bailey also attended Teen Talk.
I wanted to learn about a healthy relationship and the STDs and how to prevent, like, having a child and stuff, because I'm not financially stable. I would like to learn the mistakes that can happen.
Isom's older sister had her first baby at 16. Isom says he and his girlfriend planned to delay sex.
I promised her that I would wait until after marriage because it's special to me, because kids all the time talk about having sex and just being with someone in the bed, and I don't think like that. I think that you should be more respectful to them and not just think about yourself and your own needs and wants.
Beyond the new curriculum and after-school program, McDowell County medical clinics that operate inside the high schools offer teens free contraception, including condoms and the pill, without parental consent. While these controversial changes are in the early stages, school superintendent Nelson Spencer believes they are having an impact.
We want them to be educated about all facets of life and to be able to make the right choice for them and make the choice that's going to benefit them in the future.